Hello. E4, knight f6, f4, e6, knight c3, bishop b4, queen c2, castles, and knight f3. Note that after d5 we have the same position like in the Rogozin variation, so it's a transposition where white played queen c2 on the fifth move and we castled. So this position is important for our repertoire, and that's the reason why we play d5 on knight f3, because c5 is also playable in this position, but d5 sticks with our repertoire. And now, of course, white can play a3, and after bishop c3, queen takes c3. And b6 we have no variation, and that's the reason why we should know the line with d5 in the main line. If we don't want to be tricked, we should really play this line and nothing else. C takes d5 is not the only move. White can try bishop g5 now, but I think that after c5 this position is good for black. Maybe the best for white is to take dc5 now, but we play h6 like in the spirit of the bishop g5 line. If bishop f6, queen f6, e3, then we go knight a6, rook c1, knight c5, e3, bishop c3, queen c3, queen c3, rook c3. That was the correspondence game. And the position is harmless. For example, dc, bishop c4, rook d8, king e2, and bishop d7 with the idea of playing bishop e8 and b6, so it's just an equal position. If bishop h4, then knight a6, a3, bishop c3, queen c3, and g5. And white can take on g5 and sacrifice the piece, because bishop g3 then. It's easy for black. Knight e4, queen c2, queen a5, knight d2, queen d2, queen d2, knight d2, king d2, knight c5, king e1, knight b3, rook d1, and d takes c4. That was a correspondence game, and black has no problems. So, but after g5, knight g5, we take hg, bishop g5, and we play knight e4. That's the problem for white. Because after bishop d8, knight c3, bishop h4, knight a4, it's really crazy position. C takes d5, knight 6 takes c5, before knight e4. Engine gives something 0.0. That was a correspondence game, but it's very complex endgame for both sides. So e3 is the main move, but it's easy for black. Cd, ed, h6. Now bishop f6, queen f6, that was a correspondence game. The most critical try is c5, but after knight c6, a3, bishop f5, b4, bishop c7, rook d1, a6, this position remains a correct and defense, and the position is more or less equal. So bishop h4, knight c6, and white should protect the pawn with rook d1. If a3, bishop e7, rook d1, b6, it's transposition. If c5 now, then the problem is that black plays g5, bishop g3. That was a game of Grandmaster Oparin was black, and here black should have played g4, winning the d4 pawn. Knight e5, knight d4, queen c1, and black protects the h6 pawn with knight f5. If now a3, then bishop c3, bc knight d7. Trying to exchange the knights, bishop d3 and queen g5. Black is pawn up. If bishop d3, then d4. That's the problem. Because the knight is pinned. Bishop f5 and d takes c3. And white has no time to take on the h6 and should take on c3. But then black takes on c3 and takes on f5. Castles knight e4 and black is just pawn up. So rook d1, bishop e7. Our idea is to go b6, bishop b7, and so on. So, for example, a3, protecting against knight b4, maybe, but b6, bishop d3, dc, winning a tempo, bishop c4, and knight d5, bishop g3, knight c3, queen c3, and knight a5. That was a correspondence game. work is just better in such structure. We already know that from the Rubinstein variation. Bishop e2, b6, castles bishop b7, a3, we take on c4, bishop c4, knight a5. More or less the same, bishop a2. Yeah, of course, black can try knight d5, bishop f3 was played in the correspondence game, g takes f3, knight d5, bishop d5, ad, bishop e7, queen e7, queen f5, and here black should have played knight c4, knight d5, and queen d6, and black will win b2 pawn back, so it's an equal position. Of course, let's sum up that after e3 we play c5, and it's a transposition. Already in the first video of Rubinstein variation, so really the only move is c takes d5. Of course, we take with a pawn, and white plays bishop g5 or bishop f4. This video is about bishop f4. It's the recommendation of Jan Gustafsson for Chess24 video series with white. But in the video series with black, he gives the line that equalizes. So black plays c5. If now e3, then c4. Bishop e2, knight c6, castles, knight e7, with the idea of playing knight f5, bishop f5. So white should take on c5, and Jan Gustafsson gave the line knight d4, e3, bishop f5, bishop d3, bishop c3, bc, knight d7, c6, bc, castles, like in the correspondence game, with small advantage for white. But queen a5 is better for black, and black has no problems. For example, knight d2 is a bad move because d4 and black is better. If e3, then bishop f5, that is the tactical reason of queen a5 move. It was game, black was better. Rook c1, another tactical idea that we take on a2, e3, knight f4, bishop d3, bishop c3, bc, queen c2, bishop e6, and black is fine because c5 pawn is hanging. If a3, then another tactical reason, queen a5 move is knight f4, bishop d2, knight d2, queen d2, bishop c3, queen c3, queen c3, bc, knight a6, and it's just an equal endgame. So maybe the best move is to play bishop d2, knight c6, a3, and black plays bishop g4, bishop e2, rook a8. Don't take c5 pawn, just to continue your development. Now nothing at all for white. For example, knight d4, bishop e2, knight c6, bc, knight e2, knight e4, bishop c3, bishop c3, knight c3, knight c5, castles, knight e6 with an equal position, or castles, then we play d4, a3, bishop c3, bc, d3, it's a good move, bishop d3, bishop f3, gf, queen c5, bishop e2, and queen h5, and black has full compensation for the sacrifice pawn. So rook d1, maybe the best move for white, queen c5, castles, but now bishop f3, bishop f3, d4, ed, knight d4, queen d3. The problem is that black takes back the bishop, knight b3, queen c2, knight d2. Of course, black can play knight d4 and it's a draw, but after knight d2, rook d2, rook d2, queen d2, bishop c3, queen c3, queen c3, bc, b6, that endgame is also very equal and probably very drawish. So let's make some conclusions. I really think that white should play c takes d5 now, because otherwise, if bishop g5, then c5, and white should be careful not to be in worst position. Other moves are transpositions, and after cd, d bishop f4, we play c5, and dc queen a5 is an important move, and black successfully equalizes. But this line is tricky for white player, because bishop f4 is a rare move. So thanks for watching this video, and see you again soon. In the next video we will talk about bishop g5. Goodbye.